Did you know that in Massachusetts, the racial disparities in the juvenile justice system are among the worst in the nation? Did you know that a delinquent mistake in childhood can add years to an adult criminal sentence? And did you know that most data on the juvenile justice system's 32 decision points are uncollected or hidden from other agencies and the public? Legislators and policymakers are deprived of necessary information to make the juvenile justice system more effective and fairer. I share these insights as a member of the Social Justice Coalition of South Church in Andover. As a part of the United Church of Christ, we are a faith-based group working to do justice and to love kindness and to walk humbly with God. When we learned of the unjust racial disparities for our children in the juvenile justice system, and that many of Massachusetts inmates had experienced foster care as children, we were deeply disturbed. Scripture called us to action. This is not politics. This is care for our state's children of color and of poverty. Though there were a dozen worthy juvenile justice legislative bills to support, we identified two bills to focus on since we are new to this work. These bills have made their way through the State House, out of joint legislative committees, and gone on to the Senate Ways and Means Committee. An email from a constituent living within a legislator's district has real power to gain support for a bill, which is why we're appealing to you. First, consider Senate Bill 1558, an act improving juvenile justice data collection. This bill will dramatically improve transparency and accountability in the juvenile justice system. There are almost three dozen decision points in the entire juvenile process, and this process crosses from municipality to county to state agencies. Today, Massachusetts fails to report crucial data at some of the most significant decision points in the system. When and by what causes along the way do racial disparities arise? Where are they exacerbated? We don't know. Key data are not collected or are kept from the public eye. We do know our jails and prisons incarcerate disproportionately more people of color than are reflected in our population. Senate Bill 1558 mandates comprehensive, uniform, reliable, and publicly accessible data. Once problems are identified and quantified, systemic racism can be unveiled. Inequities in enforcement and processing can be pinpointed. Just and cost-effective remedies can be proposed. This bill will create opportunities for more effective and fairer justice for all our state's children. The second bill we are championing is Senate Bill 2670, the act to prevent the imposition of mandatory minimum sentences based on juvenile adjudication or convictions. When the district attorney prosecutes certain charges, a mandatory minimum is applied, which enhances the sentence based on the person's past record, including juvenile convictions. Today in Massachusetts, the mistakes of a 13-year-old child can add years onto an adult sentence. Based on the sparse data available to the public, we have come to understand this practice causes structural racism reaching into adulthood, since the convicted 13-year-old is more likely to be a child of color. White children are not ensnared at a young age as frequently as children of color. When entangled with the criminal justice system, often they are processed without a long-standing record. So the black or brown adult defendant is more likely to have a juvenile record and then more vulnerable to the district attorney's harsh sentences or plea bargain on lesser charges. 95% of criminal cases are settled by plea bargains. With passage of this bill, the severity of a sentence can still be in the judge's hands, and violent criminals can still face a mandatory minimum. We can treat all our children in Massachusetts more justly. Please join us in this effort. Your influence as a constituent carries weight with your senator.